Hello and welcome to the episode 47 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include a meeting with a future MP, a live appearance at the Ed Sullivan Show, and a trip to India. On the 16th of February 1961, the Beatles with Pete Best on drums performed at the Casanova Club and then at the Litherland Town Hall, both in Liverpool. It was a replay of their St. Valentine's Day concert in both venues. Another double feature in 1962. The Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums, performed at the Technical College Hall in Birkenhead for the second of three consecutive Friday nights at that venue. Later that night, they graced the stage of the Tower Ballroom in Wallasey for the Panto Ball, an event put together by promoter Sam Leach. In 1963, the Beatles appeared for the first and last time in Oxfordshire, with an engagement at the Cafax Assembly Rooms in Oxford. It was also the band's first booking with John Smith, one of the most influential London promoters at the time. For the occasion, the lads shared the stage with the Madisons. While in Oxford, the Beatles met Geoffrey Archer, who was just a student at the time, but who would go on to become a writer, a Conservative Party Member of Parliament, a peer, and a convicted perjurer after he denied it under oath to having paid a prostitute for sex. Archer invited the Beatles to the Brasenose College Senior Common Room and talked them into performing at a charity concert the following 12th of June in Liverpool. On the 16th of February 1964, a Sunday, the Beatles appeared for the second time on the Ed Sullivan Show, this time from the Deauville Hotel in Miami Beach, Florida. Following a 2 p.m. rehearsal that was filmed but not broadcast, the show was aired live between 8 and 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time in front of a crowd of 2,600 people. The police had to intervene to calm down some 900 people that, having received a ticket for the performance by CBS, were denied entrance to the premises. I couldn't find a reason for this decision, but I suspect it had to do with minimizing the chance of commotion inside the Deauville. The performance of She Loves You, This Boy, All My Loving, I Saw Her Standing There, From Me to You, and I Want to Hold Your Hand was remarkable more for the decision of having the Beatles as second in importance to Mitzi Gaynor in the show than for musical reasons. It was a peculiar choice in face of how much hysteria Beatlemania had spurred in millions of American fans and on the considerable success of the Beatles' first appearance on the show. Being watched by approximately 70 million people at home, the show was followed by a party thrown by the hotel owner, Morris Landsberg. In 1965, the Fab Four were at the EMI's headquarters in Manchester Square, in London, to receive several gold discs and gifts from CEO Sir Joseph Lockwood for their success around the world. In the afternoon, the Beatles were again at the EMI studios in Abbey Road to complete their work on I Need You and Another Girl, with overdubs of additional vocals and instruments between 2:30 and 5 p.m. Among other overdubs, I Need You saw George Harrison on his 12-string Rickenbacker playing a rhythm part with a volume pedal, with some difficulties. He had a hard time coordinating his foot with his hand, and so, for some takes, John Lennon had to kneel in front of him and produce the desired effect, turning the guitar volume control. For Another Girl, Paul McCartney recorded a guitar solo. Then, between 7 and 10 p.m., the band recorded 14 takes of Yes It Is, which was chosen as the B-side of their next single. Another recording session in 1967. Between 7 p.m. and 1:45 a.m., the Beatles were at the Abbey Road EMI Studios, working on vocal and bass overdubs for Good Morning, Good Morning, The resulting take 10 was ready for further work down the line and can be heard on the Anthology 2 album. A monomix of the song was completed before the end of the session and given to producer George Martin, who had to score a part for brass instruments for the song. Finally, in 1968, the Harrisons and the Lennons landed in New Delhi, India, at 8:15 a.m. They were met by the Beatles' assistant Mal Evans and by actress Mia Farrow, who was another guest of Maharishi Mahesh Yogi. Unmolested by the usual fanfare of journalists and nosy fans, the group got into three taxis and travelled for 150 miles, about 240 kilometers, reaching Rishikesh, where they would have studied transcendental meditation with the Maharishi. They took possession of their simple stone-built bungalows and started to enjoy the peaceful atmosphere of the surrounding area. This concludes another episode of What a Fab Day. The only task left is to remind you to check out www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to make me feel your appreciation for my work on this podcast and on other music-related series. As usual, you can find a bibliography of sorts for What a Fab Day linked in the episode description. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.